Hi, this is Judi at Judi in the Kitchen. Today I'm going to show you how to make some fabulous black-eyed peas with rice and vegetables. Black-eyed peas like you've never had before. They're fabulous. But first you want to make sure that you have some cooked rice on hand and some cooked black-eyed peas, whether they're canned, the ones that you like out of the can, or dried and they've already been cooked. All right, I have my skillet warming up over just a little over medium heat, and I'm gonna reduce it just slightly, but it's still around medium heat. I'm actually gonna measure out 2 tablespoons of extra virgin olive oil. Woo, you can see my can is warm. That's a good thing. Now I'm gonna add some vegetables to it. Here I have roughly 1/3 cup of chopped onion. My recipe that I put together calls for 4 medium cloves of garlic. These are pretty large, so I'm just using 3. Again, you know, that's really a seasoning. When you're talking about seasoning, it's a matter of personal preference. You can always adjust it. I have 1 stalk of celery that I have diced up, and 1/2 of a pretty large bell pepper that I've diced up. Oh boy, it's already smelling good. You can see this is going to make quite a bit here. You're going to wind up with probably a good 5-6 servings, and we're talking about large servings. Serve it with some crusty French bread and it would be really good. Okay, now this is going to have a good chance to saute for a good while. I'm going to add some other stuff now. I have 1 cup of frozen corn and 1 cup of frozen sliced carrots. You could use fresh carrots, fresh corn, frozen, canned, whatever. I did not thaw these out because the moisture in here is actually going to be okay. Now, I know this is going to cool the pan down, but we're going to add it anyway. I'm going to go ahead and add some seasoning so that that can get aromatic as well. And what we've got are some dried thyme leaves, roughly 3/4 teaspoon there. Again, you can adjust that, add a little more if you want, maybe up to 1 teaspoon or a little more. I've got about 1.5 teaspoons of dried parsley. 1/4 teaspoon of salt, a little dash of pepper, and a good pinch of some red pepper flakes. And again, seasoning is really a very personal thing, and you can adjust that any way you need to. And actually, I might go in and add a little bit more of the thyme, but I'm going to allow this to cook some. Now you see my pan has gotten cool, and that's okay. What I'm going to do is bring the heat up just a little bit and allow this to cook until those carrots are warmed up and just a slight bit more tender. And when needed, when this gets a little too dry, and it's going to have some moisture in there from the frozen vegetables, but when it starts to get dry, I'm going to add up to 3 tablespoons of water, 1 tablespoon at a time, and I'm going to cover it to allow them to steam and get those vegetables so that they're not frozen and just slightly cooked. And I'll be right back with you as soon as we're to that point, and it won't take long. All right, as you can see, this is looking really good, and from the smell of it, I can tell I want to add just a little bit more of this thyme. I'm just going to add a couple more pinches to it, and I think that will be good. And now I'm going to add 1 cup of cooked rice, and this is a generous cup. This is brown rice, but you use whatever rice you want. And this is roughly 1 3/4 cups of dried black-eyed peas that I have cooked, and they're plain. I didn't put them in bacon or anything like that in there. They're plain because I wanted them that way for this. Stir that together a little bit, and you can see it's starting to look really pretty. And now I have 1 can of Italian diced tomatoes. not drained. We want that liquid in there. We need some liquid in this dish. And really all we want to do is stir this together and allow it, I'll cover it up and allow it to warm up. And when everything is heated, it is done. If you see that it's too dry, add another tablespoon of water. I only added 2 tablespoons earlier, so I think I'm going to go ahead and add that third tablespoon of water right now, just so that there's a little bit more moisture in there. And I'm going to cover it up, turn this heat down a little bit, and just allow it to sit there for just a minute or two until everything is warm and it's ready to be served. And here is the finished dish, black-eyed peas with rice and vegetables, and it is so good and so easy to make. Serve it with a crusty slice of French bread or even a wedge of buttery polenta would be fabulous. Let me urge you to give this recipe a try. Is black-eyed peas better than I've ever had them before? Let me know if you try them. Send me some comments below. This is Judy at Judy in the Kitchen. Have a great day.